Hey, what's up, Impact Wrestling fans? BQ here with the Impact Lounge. Hit that subscribe button, Impact Wrestling fans. So many of you have seen the photo floating around the internet, and I mean, if you're hearing me speak right now, you're staring at the photo right now, but Impact Wrestling has returned to the four-sided ring. Now, I'm not trying to act like I'm some big shit, but I knew that this was coming, but unlike many others, I have journalistic integrity. And I don't like to get on the wrong side of my contacts, whether that contact be, you know, first person or third person, whatever it is. You know, I try to have some integrity, but I did know this was coming. Many people are very upset. Many people like it. And, you know, we got to put it like this. The six-sided ring was kind of for the fans. And it was something that had a history and everything. But kind of what some of you guys got to see, what I want to, you know, challenge you to try to understand is that the wrestlers, this was most likely a very popular move for the wrestlers. And that's kind of what it boils down to when you're trying to negotiate with, you know, other talent coming in, and you've got this ring that they have no experience wrestling in. You know, even AJ Styles famously said how hard that ring was. You remember Drago falling off the top rope at Slammiversary because the ropes aren't at a 90-degree angle. They have what's that on the logo? The logo on the side, Switch or Stitch or whatever the hell it is, that streaming platform. So that's on there as well. So that could be a good partnership. That's a growing digital platform. That's been very popular with people. But Johnny Impact had said on a conference call not too long ago that he felt the six-sided ring was... It wasn't a conference call. It was an interview with Jim Ross. He felt that the six-sided ring was unnecessary. So I kind of, you know, of course I want to know what you guys think. I know some of you are pissed off. I already know that. I've seen social media. But it is what it is. They're trying to get the TNA stank off things, and some people really, really want it to be TNA and remain TNA, but the fact of the matter is it's just not that company anymore. There are elements I miss. You know, on the GWN, watching Impact from last year, not last year, you know, 2017, but 2016, like, even though that was like a struggling year with Billy and Dixie and all that, like, that product was actually a lot better than what we've had. You know what I mean? Like, I miss certain things about the TNA side. I really do. But I'm also understanding that look at the financial situation. Look at the viewership. Look at all these factors. They're going to have to make moves to be more attractive to, you know, and potential free agents. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. And please hit that subscribe button. Peace.